Okay.
Yeah, so so this is a voiceover IP project by one of our students from San Francisco State, and this allows us to place a phone call from one laptop to another, and so you could have a village, say, with 50 laptops, and some kid wants to call his friend, you'd get on there and say, call Bill, and you'd be on the phone and you could talk to Bill. So the laptop doubles up as a phone. And so this is something she did for her thesis, and now we need to work some more on it to actually make it into a real sugar activity.
Oh, cool.
Yep.
What does it look like on screen?
Oh, right now it's just a text running inside the terminal. So it gives you a little text menu that says, answer a call, terminate a call, call up here, the call goes to that laptop over there. And you can sort of hear the ambient noise from the other end and what people are talking about and so on. So as far as this thing will hop, say, up to the end of the corridor or in the hallway, it'll work. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. So you know, this is one of the ways where we're able to get our students involved, right? So she got her master's thesis, she got something to work on, it's meaningful, and you know, it'll go out into the field. And so we are able to satisfy multiple objectives by involving the students at the university in these kinds of projects.
Excellent.
Yeah.
How long do you think you're away from having it as an app?
If we get one of these people here to commit to writing this, within a week this should be ready.
Okay.
I mean, it actually works. It needs a pretty face, you know. She had to go back to Morocco, so she wasn't able to complete it. So yeah, I mean, a week, and this could actually be here.
Yeah. Cool.
So you could go ring ring, and so I think she wanted to call it the ring ring activity, and you would be able to call somebody on the XO to talk.
So you can call a phone number.
Right. So right now this is going from that XO to here,
uh-huh.
And you can actually.
Hello.
So it works from one XO to the other,
uh-huh.
And you don't need any server in the middle or any of those things.
Uh-huh.
If you wanted to call
anywhere.
Well, as far as the mesh goes, you know, the
network.
If you wanted
in a neighborhood, maybe that you could see Wi-Fi.
Yeah, it'll work over Wi-Fi.
Uh-huh.
It'll work over the mesh. Now, if you wanted to call somebody, say on a regular phone, then you would have to add an asterisk or like a phone gateway,
uh-huh.
And there are lots of services you can sign up for, and so you'd be able to actually dial somebody's number from here.
Uh-huh.
And call out.
Uh-huh.
So the XO doubles up on the phone.
Somebody was Robert was telling me that it's a light activity. It doesn't
yes.
take as much
space
as Skype.
Yeah. No. This is.
But it won't do Skype. What Skype?
This is an XO1,
uh-huh.
and this will run very nicely on an XO1. It's nothing like Skype. Skype
right.
will just bog down the whole thing.
Uh-huh.
I've tried running Skype on an XO1,
and it doesn't work.
It works, but it's very slow because Skype is not designed for these things.
Right.
So here, you know, she was able to take, it's an open source project, so she took the code and compiled it,
uh-huh.
and you know, she's got the settings exactly the way we want it. And then it, you know, so this was part of her master's thesis.
Uh-huh. I saw the poster.
Yeah, so it took her about, it took her over 2 semesters to work on this, do the research, collect the data. For instance, you know, if there are 10 conversations across, you know, multiple XOs, at what point is it too much?
Uh-huh.
You know, what about the battery consumption, the CPU?
Uh-huh.
So she did all of those things.
Wow.
And it's amazing. You can have 10 XOs talk at the same time.
Really? Like a conference call?
And no voice degradation. So,
wow.
Yeah.
So, what are the reasons?
That's great.
Thank you.